Hey, what's up guys? Today I'm gonna show you how you can integrate Firebase Crashlytics into your project. So guys, it is a very interesting tool that will be helpful to log all the crashes of your applications which are currently running on the devices. Okay, so guys, basically this helps to maintain the applications which having the crashes, okay, or having some loopholes in your applications. So guys, I would like to recommend you, if you want to secure application or if you want to increase the performance of your application, you can integrate the Crashlytics with your application. So kindly watch the complete video to learn how you can integrate Crashlytics with your project. Okay, so guys, let's start. So for that you will require a Google account or a Firebase account, okay, and nothing much with the XCODE. Okay, so this is your XCODE project. This is a very basic setup. There is nothing, but it's a view controller, simple view controller. Okay, and here as you can see, now let me go on the our Chrome. So this is our Firebase console. So if you are having a Google account, you can directly go land on the Firebase console. Okay, and here as you can see, this will be your first screen if you are not having any project related to Firebase. Okay, so if you want to create a Firebase project, so let's click on the create a new project. So I think I have reached on my limit, so it is showing this alert message. By the way, here you can give your Firebase project name. Okay, so for right now, for me, I'm going to give the Firebase Crashlytics. It will generate a unique ID for your Firebase project. Okay, so that it will maintain the uniqueness for your project. Okay, so let's create the project. Okay, so it will take some time to create your project, so let's wait for that moment. So guys, as you can see, our project is successfully created. Now let me click on the continue, and this is our project. So let me click on this project. So as you can see guys, now it is going to say from which platform you want to integrate your Firebase. Okay, so let me choose the iOS. Obviously we want to create an XCODE project. Okay, for iOS project. Okay, so let me, now it is going to ask for bundle identifier of your application so that it can recognize your project, okay, on the Firebase. So for that, let's go on your XCODE project and let me click on this project target. Okay, and here in the general tab you can see your bundle identifier is this. Okay, so let me copy it and let's go on our register app here and let me paste it here, and after that click me on register app. So after clicking, it will take some time. Okay, so it is successfully registered. Now it is going to say please download this info plist file. So let me download this file. Okay, so I hope I have downloaded successfully. Okay, so let me remove these two files first of all, and let me delete once again it. Okay, so let me move it to trash, I think. Okay, move to trash. Now let me download once again. Okay, because if you are not, because I need to, okay, by the way, this is our Google service info plist file. Now let me import this file into our project. Okay, so here as you can see guys, make sure you are checked with the copy items if needed and the edit folder to create groups. Okay, so let me click on the finish. As you can see guys, our info Google info plist has been added, having the acknowledgement about your Firebase project. Okay, so after that what we need to follow the step here, just click on the next. Now it is going to say please create a port file, okay, for our project. So for that, let's jump on our XCODE project. Click your project target. Okay, so just right click and show in Finder. So it is going to open your project within Finder. Okay, right click on this XCODE project file. Okay, and open with terminal. Okay, so our project is this. Now let's go back one directory, and now it is going to say now here we need to write a command that is pod init. So it is going to create a pod file within our root directory. Okay, so as you can see within Finder, there is a port file. Okay, so now you can edit this port file. Okay, so I'm going to edit this port file from the console again. Okay, so let me edit this file, and here you need to press the I button, and so that you can insert the things. Okay, now let me install this port Firebase Analytics. Okay, so for that let me go on the console again and let me paste it here, press escape button, colon WQ and exclamation mark. After that you can install your port here. Okay, so it will take some time to install your port if you are running first time. Okay, but for in my case it is successfully installed. Now after installation of this, now let's go on the again console. Now let's click on the next. Now it is going to say please configure your Firebase app. Okay, so now let's go on the XCODE project. So before going on the XCODE project, you need to close your XCODE. Why? Because we have generated a new file, that is you know what, this XE workspace. So you need to open your project every time from the XE workspace, not from the XCODE project, if you are using the port files. Okay, I think you know very well what I'm trying to say. Okay, so now let me open this XE workspace project. Okay, so okay, so it is successfully opened, I think. Okay, so it is successfully opened. Now guys, let's go in the app delegate. Okay, and let me import the Firebase. Okay, so let me import Firebase. It is taking time. Okay, so Firebase, and now here you can say Firebase app dot configure. Okay, so it is going to configure your application for your Firebase. Okay, so let's click on the next. Now it is saying please build and run your project. Okay, so that it can recognize your project is running or not. Okay, successfully integrated with the Firebase or not. So it will take some time to run it. So guys, I think our application is almost up and running. So let's wait. I think it's running successfully. It is checking still now. Okay, so let's run it once again. Maybe okay, so let me run it once again, or let me stop first of all. Why it is taking time? Let me run it once again. Okay, so I think now it should successfully checked. So let's wait. Okay, it is taking some time. So maybe let me refresh it. Let me refresh it. Okay, fine. So after refreshing, I think we are done with our iOS project. So guys, as you can see, now it is showing our iOS project. So let's click on this iOS project, but nothing happens. Okay, so now we have just integrated the Firebase with our project, but not Crashlytics. Okay, so for that you need to go in the left section and you can see the quality section. Okay, so this is the quality section, and let's click on the quality section. It's gonna expand the menu and you can see the Crashlytics option. Okay, so let me click on this Crashlytics option, and it's gonna show you some instruction. So set up Crashlytics. Okay, so if you are creating a new Firebase app, then you can choose this. If you are migrating your Fabric app which you have integrated with the Fabric, okay, so you can choose this. So for right now we need to choose the no. Why? Because we are creating a new project. Okay, so let me click on the next, and now go to the Crashlytics doc. Okay, so let's jump on the Crashlytics doc and let's see what are the steps here we need to follow to integrate the Crashlytics with our project. Okay, so as you can see guys, it is saying to create a new project. Okay, blah blah blah, we have done with this. Now then in the step 2, you need to install the Crashlytics SDK. okay, so for that you need to install two more ports. Okay, so for that let's go in the XCODE, and here within the ports you can find out your port file. Okay, so now here just paste it here, and let me remove the versions from here. Okay, and after removing the version, now let me go on the console again and let me install the port once again. Okay, so I think the port has been successfully installed. Let's build our application. Okay, application is built successfully. Now what we need to do here, just go on the doc once again, and it is going to say code repo update. So you need to do it by yourself, okay, because my repo is already updated, so I'm not going to run this command in console. But if you are not having any updated repository of Cocoa code, then you need to update, okay. By the way, here I have done this. Now we need to initialize the Crashlytics. For that you need to copy this command and just go in your project and let's choose the target and just go on the build phases, and here you need to add the run script. So if you are having any option run script here, then you can expand and you can edit, okay, because there is no nothing. So we need to create a new run script phase. So as you can see guys, there is a section of run script. Now let me paste the run script here which we have copied, okay. So after this, now you need to copy this line also. Basically this line is only for the XCODE 10 and above versions, but if you are lying with the XCODE 9 or 8, then you need to escape this line. But I hope you are also having XCODE 10 or 11, I don't know, okay. So let's click on this plus icon and let's paste the line here, okay. So make sure you are having like this statements, okay. Maybe you can maybe there will be a problem if you are you know what, entering a wrong information, okay. So by the way, we are done with this, okay. But guys, one more configuration I want to tell you while doing this, that is what very important concept guys, very important. Just go in the build settings and here you need to go in the last and in the you know what I'm looking, I'm looking for right is not shift compiler, okay. So right is not showing, okay. By the way, we need to go in the our target, just select your target basic, and here you can see the debug information format. You need to make it as the DWRF with DSYM file. So guys, this is a very important concept you need to do, and the same thing I think you need to follow in the build settings, okay. So we have just applied the build settings within the build settings also. So let me search for the debug information. Why it is not showing? Okay, so let me choose the all and then we can I think find out, okay. So as you can see guys, the build options, so this build option should be with a DWRF with DSYM file required, okay. So I hope you are done with this also, okay. So yeah, we are done with this, and so guys, now let's go on the next step, that is what, build and run your application, okay. So build and run our application, okay. So for that, this is our application. Now build and run our application, okay. So let's see, and it is going to listen our request, okay. So after listening the request, if we have successfully built and run, the screen will going to be changed, okay, automatically. So we have run successfully, and let me run it once again, okay. So okay, so as you can see guys, the screen has been changed after successfully run. Now go to the Crashlytics dashboard here. Now you can log your crashes here, okay. So let me generate a crash and let me show you how the crash is going to be logged, okay. So for that, what I'm going to do, just go on the main storyboard, okay. So for main storyboard here, I want to add a button actually, okay. So let me add the button here, okay. And let me make it in the center of the screen, and let me change the text here, okay. So you can give like crash here, okay. And okay, so let me create the outlet of the button so that we can crash on the clicking of the button, okay. So click button crash, okay. So this will be my you know what, outlet. So let me go in the view controller, let me close this window, okay. So now here Now here guys, what I want to do, I want to crash the application. So there are two ways basically. First one is the Crashlytics provides a method to crash the application. Okay, so let me choose this Crashlytics dot shared instance dot crash. Okay, so after clicking on this button, it is going to crash our application. Now here is the important thing guys, what if you are crashing your application first time, very first time. Now guys, make sure you are doing this whatever I'm saying. So if you are crashing your application very first time, then make sure first of all you need to run your project successfully. After that you need to stop the application from the Xcode and then just go in the simulator and run the app from the home screen, and let's click on the crash here. Okay, so after successfully crash, your application is going to be closed automatically. After closing automatically, you need to run your application once again. Okay, after running once again, now let me refresh this dashboard and let me show you the crash has been logged or not. So I hope the crash should be logged. Okay, so guys, as you can see, there is one crash, one user affected, and the crash in the view controller.swift file with line number 20. Okay, so let me show you. So as you can see, this is our view controller.swift file having the line number 20, means almost this line. Okay, so this is the cause of our crash. So guys, this is a very helpful while your application is live and your users are facing crash problem. Okay, so I hope you are able to understand what I'm trying to say. Okay so we are done with this. So guys, I hope I was able to tell you what is the process, how you can crash the application, how you can log the application, crash logs. Okay, so you can close your issues from the top as we have seen. Okay, so let me show you once again. Okay, so our application is crashed. Let me run it once again. Let me refresh my Crashlytics dashboard. Okay, and so as you can see guys, we have successfully run, and now once again the crash here. Now let me click on the crash. Okay, so as you can see guys, there are two total events, total crashes basically, and the current crash is this. You can see all the threads information here. Okay, so you can close the issue from here. If you don't want to close, just go back and your crash will be still here. Okay, yeah, so one user affected. And if you want to filter out your crashes, you want to see the last 24 hours crash, you can see from here. So I hope you are able to integrate the Crashlytics with our iOS application. So guys, let me know all the sessions from you. So if you are having any problem related to integrating Crashlytics, so I would like to recommend, kindly go from the start of the video and watch and follow each and every step which I have followed, and make cross check after a single minute if you have followed all the instructions which I have told in this video. And after this, I am going to give you the guarantee that your Crashlytics gonna work. So guys, if you really like the video, then hit the like button. If you are having any suggestion or if you are having any problem, you can comment in the comment section. And if you are first time on my channel, then you need to subscribe my channel. Okay guys, I'm just kidding. Okay, so you can subscribe the channel, and if you really don't like this video, then you can hit the dislike button also. Okay, so guys, I will see you in the next video with a new topic. Bye bye, take care, happy coding, have a nice day.